Hi there, I'm Christopher Harrison, Senior Cloud Advocate inside of Microsoft Cloud and AI. And in this video, what I want to explore is how we can implement what's commonly known as routing, which is telling a web framework, hey, if a user goes to this particular URL, performs this particular action, this is now the code that I want you to execute in response to this. Now in Django, the way that this is done is by using what Django calls a URLconf file, which is a collection of paths or a collection of routes, as a lot of other frameworks would call it, which is again, me saying, hey, when a user goes to this path, this is where I want you to send that request. Now, the global file for this is going to be inside of your project. And you'll notice that that's going to be called urls.py. And so right down here, this is the global for the entire project. And eventually, what I'm going to need to do is to tell Django through this file where all of my URL confs are set up, where all of my routes set up, so that way it knows what to do. Now note the name here, URL patterns. This is going to become important because this is going to be our URL conf. That's what we're going to be doing here. Now, keep this urls.py file in mind. We're going to come back to it. But for right now, and I'm going to close this out to hopefully avoid any confusion. I'm going to close that out. I'm going to go back to my app. Go back to my Rella Cloud app. And inside of this app, I'm going to create a brand new urls.py file. And so this is going to be specific to my app. Now, the good news is that in a lot of Django projects, you're going to find yourself really focused in on like one app. And so you won't have to worry too much about trying to remember which urls.py file it is that you want. So for right now, let's just keep all of our attention on the one right here. This is the one that's inside of our Rella Cloud app. Now, what I need to do is I need to bring in a helper library for me to start to set up my my routes or my paths. So I'm going to say from Django urls, import path. Now this path function here, this is going to take three parameters as we're going to see, and we're going to list them all off inside of URL patterns. And this little snippet right here is being given to me by this wonderful extension here called Django. We'll make sure that there's a list in the video description down below. And it has a lot of great snippets and other things that will help you out. Definitely worth installing into VS Code. So that's where that automatic URL patterns came into play. And if you remember, we highlighted that a minute ago, that again, this name is important. That's going to be our URL conf. And so our path is now going to look for two main things. The first is going to be the route. So this is where is the user going inside of our application? So I'm going to leave this as a blank string, set this up as our default path, and then I need to point them at the function. And so we've got inside of our urls.py inside of our views.py our two functions, index and about. So let me bring those in. So I'm going to say from dot import our views. And then now we're going to say for the default, let's go to index. And then I'm going to go ahead and give this a name and let's call this index. This is going to become important a little bit later when we want to go find this particular route programmatically, that we never want to hard code in a path if we can just look it up instead. So we'll just give that a name. Then I'm going to add in my second here. This is going to be for about, and then our views about, and then we'll give this a name of about. Okay, cool. So now I've got my URL conf created for my Rella Cloud app. I've got my index and my about set up. So if you just go to the root of the project, we're going to show you the index page. And if you go to /about, then we'll show you the about page. Now, again, this needs to be registered globally. It needs to be registered inside of the project. So I'm going to go back to that project. I'm going to go back into that existing URLs pie. And now let's go ahead and add this in. So the way that we do this is you'll notice that there's already that from Django URLs import path. I'm going to add one other helper function here called include. And what include will allow me to do is it will allow me to include in that URL conf that I created a couple of seconds ago. And if you remember, that was relicloud.urls, like that. And so now what this is doing is this is instructing our project, hey, open this file up, go look for our URL patterns here and import those in. So now Django knows about these, and now Django knows, hey, if somebody just goes to, you know, our domain name, we'll open up the index function. And if somebody goes to about, then we'll go to the about function. Let's see this in action here. Let me make sure that my project is still running. It is, that looks good. Cool, let me open up my browser here. And I'm just gonna hit refresh. It's going to go back to a basic path, and I do get an error message. I want, let me just restart this. There we go. Okay, I just needed to restart my server. So all I did was just hit Control C to stop it. I'm getting a couple little warnings. I don't worry too much about those right now. And I just reran my server by using that Python manage py run server. So that was all I did to fix the little bug. And so now what you're gonna notice is when I go to 127.0.0.1, that it, colon 8000 in my case, that it will give me that index page. And if I go to about and hit enter, that here is that about page. And that really is then kind of the pattern that you're going to fall into whenever you're adding in new views, is that you'll create the view. So you'll come over to views py file, add that in. You'll go into your URLs py file. You'll add that into that URL patterns and just sort of lather, rinse, repeat as you go through and continue to grow out your project. And so that's how you can start to implement how you can start to implement routing and utilize a URL conf inside of Django.